enforcement is a waste of time and doesn't have an impact, because if it really is, we should be shifting all the expenditures we make of having officers out on the streets writing these tickets and doing the enforcement. If it winds up being at the same speed anyway, then we're wasting a lot of money, and we should be changing our policy dramatically.
Right now, we cannot do the enforcement. We cannot target those motorists who are coming through Riverside at 50, 53, 55 miles an hour. Those are the ones we want to focus on, not the motorists that's going 40, 45, but the motorists that are pushing that 50 mile per hour barrier. And right now, we're already overtired. So therefore, those commuters that travel through there can run amok and drive as fast as they like.
Well, maybe I wasn't clear on what you're saying based on that study. Is it just the posting? Or is the enforcement also have no impact on the average state? It's just about the same anyway.
The study that we're talking about doesn't address enforcement. It addresses what the speed limits are done based on when you raise or lower. Because the myth is you raise the speed limit, people are going to drive faster. But that the studies show that that's not the case.
Are there studies that go the extra step and determine whether actually doing the enforcement, writing tickets, impacts that? Or is it possible that even so, I assume enforcement winds up being part of that fact then?
Well, enforcement is a tool, a resource for the police department. So when there's a community outcry of speeding problem, we can go out and work it immediately. When there's no resource such as the survey, we can't do anything. We just have to say, I'm sorry, but we can't do anything at this time. Therefore, by having the survey in place, it allows the officer of the police department, upon request of the community, whether it be a city council member, or an incident, there might be an incident where there was some speeding going on, resulting in a fatal traffic collision. We need to go out and address that and target it, because the tool is there, the resource of the survey.
Okay, well, I'll ask one more time, and then we'll let it go for now. Can you tell whether it actually has an impact, whether doing the enforcement? If you have a traffic fatality because too many people are speeding, does it have an impact when you send out an officer and write
a ticket? Yes, there's correlation between enforcement and reduction of traffic collisions. There's been shown that with the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration on their own website to show a correlation between enforcement, bringing speeds down through enforcement, and maintaining speeds through enforcement. There is a direct correlation between traffic enforcement and reduction of traffic collisions.
So the bottom line of what you're saying is posted speed limits have no impact, but the actual enforcement is what has the impact.
The posted speed limit is established by the service. The enforcement allows us to do our job at that particular time.
But you want to set the posted speed limit close to what people are driving, or it will result in additional potential for accidents. And also, there's a lot of concern by the community that by setting speed limits and increasing enforcement, we're just doing it for the money. What we want to do is we want to set the speed limits at the speed that most people are already driving at, so that only that those people, 15% or so that are traveling in excess the posted speed are going to be the one to get some tickets, and we'll also
bring this back to us. Okay, this will be continued. We have three council members who have a direct relationship to this. That's Mr. Krekorian, Mr. Peretz, and Mr. Levant. I personally, as chair of this committee, have signed with the neighbors and with the bicyclists. I would rather have a lower speed posted than a higher speed, just because of safety that matters to me about the people who literally live in that block or that neighborhood or in that particular street. But I'll let this discussion continue, but I'm compelled to say that I don't care what they do, the reality is to post it or leave it at 35 and not raise it to 40. There'd be more comfort in a lot of people's minds. I have an issue like that that's 35 now. My people want to make it to 25. I want to do it at 25 because I want to respect the safety of the people who live in that block, regardless of what studies say or what the analysis are. So I'm inclined, no matter what, to be more supportive of lowering it or not raising it, whatever the issue may be. But this will be for another robust discussion on this with the three council members I mentioned, whose street it is, to continue. So if we could at this point, colleagues, I want to continue the cycle like you suggested.
Excuse me, are you continuing 4, 5, and 6, or just 5 and 6?
Five and six.
Five and six, and you approve four?
Yeah. Five and six are the two that he's asking. We're going to continue those two. What was the other one you said?
Item four was another speed revision on the Beverly Glen Boulevard.
You're okay with
that? I don't think that one has opposition.
Okay. So
it's more smooth. moving out, so it's reducing five by five and increasing by five in other areas, so it's easier.
So then we'll go forward with that.
Yes, go ahead.
No, I think that after hearing this presentation about 800 times on this subject, is that if you arbitrarily reduce the speed and it's inconsistent with the flow of traffic, then what you'll end up with is people complaining about speed, and the police have an inability to do about it. So that's basically what you're going to create. And so if you set the speed limit based on the survey, you now have the tools to go out and impact the traffic, because people will drive as to their, what they think their ability is to get through the roadway. There's a small percentage of people who choose not to. That's who the officers go out and attempt to correct their behavior. And the number one impact on traffic violations is enforcement. So if you want to have no tools and people driving at a speed above the sign because they feel comfortable and no ability to enforce it, then you'll arbitrarily reduce the speed and take away that tool.
And then for your
what was your first job in the
they call it PIC. I wasn't a real traffic officer, so PIC.
Mr. Chair?
Yes, sir.
For just one moment, I wanted to suggest that when this comes back for discussion,
yes,
that that discussion might also include those areas along Riverside Drive where the speed rate would be posted lower because of schools. In fact, I attended Riverside Drive Elementary School near Coldwater Academy, and I believe that within a certain distance, that's been posted at 25. And so, when we have that further discussion, perhaps we can talk about how that relates to the rest of the city.
Excellent. Let's make sure we do that.
Officer, one important thing, I apologize. When schools are present, we don't have to have a survey. We can enforce it regardless of the survey is present or not at 25.
That's one of the points I wanted to make.
Can I ask a fast question? Downtown Toluca Lake, can you post it at 25? And then when you get west of Cahuenga, open it up? That would make sense to the community. They understand that. And then when you get near place, look at that, Ryan. Check with Glendale, check with Burbank. No comment. Thank you. Next time.
All right.